Now, Kiwi journalist David Farrier has made a successful career shining a light on oddballs and bullies, and his new film may be his most explosive yet.
It began as a series of articles about a notorious wheel clamper, Michael Organ. It's a powerful example of investigative journalism and how truth is often stranger than fiction.
Do you mind passing me a little, that little wipe at the top?
Rescue Cat Dribble is David Farrier's idea of heaven. And after making his new film, we thought he could do with the calming vibe of a cat cafe.
The teeth keep the dribble in. If we had no teeth, we'd be dribbling as well.
What's the point of the purr, do you know? Why a cat purrs?
It's like, why do cats do that thing when they see a fly and they go, kick. Have you seen that?
Yes.
What is that? No one knows. They're mystery creatures, the cat.
Mystery creatures are Farrier's obsession. And like his 2016 movie, Tickled, which lifted the lid on a man involved in dubious exploits, Mr. Organ takes us on a journey into darkness, revealing a man who is as terrifying as he is exasperating. Making it was an ordeal.
It was an ordeal. Yeah, it was one of those things where it seemed like a good idea when it started, and it seemed like it was going to be funny and quirky, and then it just got a bit bleak, really, and a bit full on.
He knows I'm making a film about him, and I think he wants to be a part of it.
He followed me down to my bedroom, and he punched me in the head 6 times.
Michael Organ is a black hole.
You kind of get taken along for the ride.
And I've fallen in.
At what point did you think this could make a really, really good documentary film?
It's when I started meeting people from the clampers' past who had a really, really weird experiences in court and just really strange experiences living with him. And I just realized this was a person who has just gone through life really just moving in on people's lives and destabilizing them in a really unusual way. And I realized that the clamping was almost a metaphor for what this person does on a bigger scale. And I just thought a film could be a really good case study in what played out. It was a similar thing to Tickled, where it started light and quirky, you know, with tickling it was like, oh, there's competitive endurance tickling, that's so interesting. With this it was like, there's a wacky clamper, but also it goes somewhere really bleak.
The problem with Michael is once he gets onto you, he won't let go.
You probably would have been quite an interesting person to know if you weren't such
a... Do you ever think that you might regret making this documentary?
I regretted it during the process. It feels great it's coming out. He's been problematic to me since I've been back. He lives to make your life miserable. That's kind of his end game, and he hasn't certainly given up on that with me.
If all that sounds mysterious, it won't be once you see the film and get some idea of the impact that Mr. Organ's had on so many lives. It may be too much to describe it as a masterpiece, but it's as fascinating and entertaining as any documentary you'll ever see.
And the best thing I could hope is that people go and they see characteristics in certain people in the film, and it almost acts as a warning that if you run into that in life, instead of kind of maybe getting drawn into that kind of personality, you get out of there. You know, you go and do something else. You come to a cat cafe and pat a cat or something instead.